Welcome to Opalesque TV. Today I am in Miami together with Paul Grassi. Paul Grassi is the leader of the hedge fund insurance group for Wells Fargo. Paul, I'm curious, why particular and special insurance for hedge fund managers?
Hedge fund insurance is very important to managers for a number of reasons. They have lots of exposures from investors, potential investors are interested in it. They have regulatory exposures that are increasing as a result of Dodd-Frank and other regulations that are growing throughout the world, not just in the US. So the manager wants to protect himself from those exposures. The policy will provide defense and indemnity protection in case there is a settlement of some sort. In addition, there are other exposures that they may have, crime from employees, kidnap and ransom exposures, all kinds of things that impact them as they're traveling throughout the world, meeting investors, and providing advisory services. Wells Fargo Insurance Services is a wholly owned subsidiary of the bank, and I started up the practice with Wells in 2004. Prior to that, I was working in a smaller brokerage and started focusing on hedge funds in general around 2000, when they were a much different complexion than they are today.
I believe that this whole insurance theme for hedge funds has been driven mostly by institutional investors over the past years. Now tell me, if I was a institutional investor or any investor now, from my perspective, what would be important for me to check about a manager's insurance?
Well, the things that you're going to look at are, who is the carrier that's providing the protection? Is it a tier one carrier, such as Travelers, Chartis, CNA, Chubb, or is it a second tier carrier? That gives you a little impact into the strength of the protection. You want to make sure that there's adequacy of the limits, which is more or less a function of what the assets under management are. And you also want to make sure that the brokerage is a strong brokerage that can provide consultative approach to providing this protection to the manager. So it's sort of a three-legged stool where you have the manager, the broker, and the carrier that all provide a service to protect both the manager and the investors.
Paul, you mentioned you have been insuring hedge fund managers for 12 years now. Over those 12 years, how has this sector changed and what has become more prominent and more important right now?
Twelve years ago when I started, managers, hedge fund managers, were more or less under the radar. They weren't generally known to the broad general public. They were sort of a unknown entity even to the insurance world. So there were no real activist funds that were written up. It wasn't sort of a generally accepted public term. The financial industry knew them and accountants and lawyers and things, but the general public was largely unaware. Over the past 12 years, as hedge funds have become more popular, there are more of them. They are grabbing a lot of headlines, some positive, some not so positive. The regulatory environment has changed dramatically, and funds themselves are changing. More managers are registered than they had ever been before, so a lot of them were not subject to the 40 Act. And managers are having outside board representation. One of the things that you see a lot that you hadn't seen in the past were so-called activist funds that will take a large position and will analyze a company and feel that if the company is overpriced, that they're going to take a visible short position in that company. And that drives a lot of things. That could potentially move the market based on the strength of that manager, whether or not that particular manager has a position in that company or not. Just making a statement about a particular company can move markets. So that kind of tells you how prominent in the financial space hedge fund managers, you know, the successful ones, the long-term ones have become. So that's a function of how well they've done performance-wise, but it's also indicative of the kind of exposures that they might face from watchdog regulatory agencies, the SEC or FSA, anywhere throughout the world. As a result of that, the insurance has to be able to respond to those issues, even if they're not invested in that particular equity. So modern insurance policies are more driven towards a broader array of exposures than they were when I started back in 2000, 2001.
Now, insurance for hedge fund managers, is this a global requirement? Is this happening also in other jurisdictions? I know you're based here in the US, but how do you deal with that globally?
It is a global exposure base. Most of our clientele are US-based, but have sub-advisors in multi-jurisdictions internationally. So we need to craft a policy that is truly worldwide in nature, so that if actions are brought in foreign jurisdictions, the policy will respond by providing defense and other kind of settlement protections. So it is a truly worldwide-based policy. The environment in the rest of the world seems to be where coverage is much more prevalent. I read recently where in the UK, over 90% of managers carry this type of insurance. In the US, the penetration of the insurance is a lot lower, although it's been growing. You know, 10 or 12 years ago, a small subset of managers had this kind of coverage. But as the funds themselves have grown and the requirement of the investors has grown, managers have picked up this insurance where previously they had not had that coverage. They're also increasing the level of protection, so the limits are going up. And of course, Dodd-Frank now requiring most of the managers to be registered, that is also driving a lot of the demand for the coverage in this country.